Hey there, happy day. Sharon Horne-Ellstrom here, but you can call me Pajama Grandma. In case we haven't met yet, go ahead and put hashtag pajama in the comments below. And I know it's the first time you are hearing my voice or seeing my face, and the first time you're kind of being exposed to the Pajama Grandma and who I am and what I'm doing and what it's all about. This is the space I use to document and journal what I'm doing as I move from the offline brick and mortar and corporate America world to online businesses in my pajamas, of course, thus the Pajama Grandma. Because I have always wanted to have, it's interesting how our desires change as we go through different stages of our life. When I was younger and starting my career and starting my life, I always wanted to have my own manufacturing business. Then I had my own manufacturing business for several decades. And now I just want to have a business that I can do what I want, when I want, where I want, with whomever I want, that allows me the freedom. It's like freedom and time are way more important to me than having the brick and mortar monetary manufacturing business. Now, I love manufacturing. I have always been excited about manufacturing. I love how things work and how they get put together and how they're made. I've always loved to take things apart and put them back together. And that was part of my personal learning curve to creating things on my own. And I love creating things. I love cooking. I love making things out of nothing and bringing them into existence so that other people can benefit from them. That's why I think I loved manufacturing so much. But now I'm going into the online world and I'm creating things, but they're less concrete things. They're more sharing ideas and how to do things and processes of becoming different things. And so it's really different. There's some similarities, but it's really different, the offline to the online world. And it's very different schools of thought. And I've spent about a year and a half now in the online world and wrapping my head around and learning and understanding. And I hadn't really been exposed to hardly anything in it before. So it is all new and exciting and fun. It's also extremely overwhelming at times because there is so much information and you have to be able to filter through and determine what information is important for you to listen to and pay attention to, and what information is just a whole lot more information. Because there's so much available to all of us nowadays. You can actually learn how to do anything you want. Anything you can imagine, you can learn how to do now because of the internet. And almost anyone has access to that. If you can get access to an internet connection, you can get access to just about anything in the world. Of course, except for the secret behind the scenes business things that people don't write down and put on the internet. And those are the things that I'm exploring and finding now that I find just fascinating. The way different businesses do things, the way different people think and come up with ideas and ways of doing things. I just find those things fascinating. So what am I doing in my online businesses this week? This week has been really focused on, last week was building my slides, putting my presentation together. This week has been delivering that presentation. I did it the day before yesterday, 2 hours and 23 minutes. I did it again yesterday I did that on Camtasia. Then I did it in front of on my Facebook Live page, on one of my live pages, and it was 2 hours and 23 minutes. It's kind of funny because I know the stories were slightly different, and I emphasized different things and I did some things differently, but it was still 2 hours and 23 minutes. And I think that I have to be okay with that because I'm making a really big offer. It's not a little offer, it's a really big offer. And I think it takes at least that long to share it and do it justice and explain what I'm offering to people. And it's my first time doing this strategy, so will it work or not? I don't know. I've helped other companies do it. I've helped other businesses do it, and it's worked for them. Will it work for me? Yes. Eventually, I'll figure it out, of course, and it will work for me. But I know that the version that I'm putting out right now isn't the final version. It's just my first attempt at my offer and what I'm offering to people, and I'll see if they like it or not. And if they don't, I'll change it up based on what people tell me they do or do not want, what their feedback is. Personally, I think I've got way too much in it. And I'm a little bit concerned that will be overwhelming to people. Because I've basically taken my 40, 45 years of knowledge and experience in different businesses and different industries and running my own businesses. And I've compiled that all into my process of helping people supersize their business. And the process is pretty simple and basic and the same. It's these steps. You follow these steps. If you do it step by step, you got it. And then you add your unique business and your twist and your art to it, I guess. It's kind of an art and science sort of thing. And I like both art and science, so it's probably why I've got so much stuff in there. But I think it might be a bit overwhelming and too much stuff. So we'll see. We'll see what the feedback is. I'm sure I'm going to do it again today. What I found is just doing these presentations, it's a little exhausting. And I'm sure down the road I'll do it actually in front of a live audience. I'm actually really excited to do it as a workshop. I've got a workshop scheduled and in front of a live audience, maybe as a presentation or a speech somewhere. Of course, it can't be 2 hours and 23 minutes in front of a speech. I will definitely get better at paring it down and shoring it up. But I think the first few runs through, they need to be long until I figure it out. They need to be the stories I've got until I figure it out and I realize, yeah, that's, I get that. I understand why I'm sharing that story, but other people don't understand. It doesn't really share the point that you want. I think there's probably a few redundancies in it that can come out, and I'll work on that. But I'm doing it. I'll keep doing it. I'm thinking I might do it every day for about the next 5 to 7 days just to get comfortable with it and practice. I'm all about practicing, right? We have to practice things. So that is my main focus. And then, of course, I'm sprinkling all the other things I have to do in there as well. So what are you up to? I would love to know what you're up to in your businesses and if there's any way, you know, I could help you. I'm all about helping other people to succeed and get what they want out of life, because we don't do any of this alone. We all need to help one another out. That's it. That's my little message for today. I've got a bit of a headache. I think it's like webinar hangover or something. I think when you talk so much, it gives you a headache. And here's the funny thing. I don't know that it's the talking so much, but I talk for 2.5 hours almost, and then I have to render it and then listen to it. Right? I have to listen to it because, okay, here's a confession. At the end of my Facebook Live one, and I'm hoping nobody finds it, because I was talking to my son-in-law about how it was super long and that I had to go to the bathroom really bad before I turned the recording off. I turned my Camtasia recording off, but I hadn't turned the Facebook Live off yet. So it's actually kind of embarrassing, but funny, because it's real life, and I did have to go to the bathroom really bad. I can't go 2.5 hours sometimes without having to go to the bathroom, especially if I'm drinking coffee or water. So we all do embarrassing things. It's part of the learning process. Yeah, I'm not super embarrassed. It's kind of embarrassing, and I'm sure I'll get feedback on it, but that's okay too, because that's something that's pretty easy to fix, right? All I got to do is remember to turn off the recording before I say I have to go to the bathroom. All right, have a great day. See you tomorrow. Bye. Oh, today was day 188.